He said PHP start support loosely typed variables, or is a what a dynamically typed language, because we don't have composite data types for the variables. Like $a here can stand for integer. $a can also mean double. $a can also mean what a char. Unlike Java or C++, where $a can only be one type of data. That's why I said PHP is a what? A loosely typed language, and it supports that typing. Then we said the file extension of PHP officially is .php. The file extension of PHP is .php. So the server is configured to recognize all file extension .php to mean what? A PHP script. So if you save your file with a different extension like TSD, the server will know what? Interpret your request for you. And then PHP works with the response and request cycle. Since it is a scripting language and runs on a server, it is based on the HTTP foundation or HTTP framework, which is made up of response and request, or request and responses. So PHP is based on HTTP. So we have a request to the server, the client make a request, and the server return a response. So in PHP, all that we are doing in the URL or in the browser, we are clicking, they are all requests. And all the previews on the servers are called what? Response. So in PHP, we have a request from the client or user. A client make a request, and the server return what? A response. So we have the client here. The client can be your laptop, or your mobile phone, or your tablet. So when you do www.google.com in your browser, you are doing an HTTP request to a server sitting in California, CA, US. That is google.com. So when you send google.com in your browser and press enter, what you are sending to the server is called an HTTP request. And when the server returns the Google home page for you, it's called an HTTP response. So PHP mostly is based on this request and response cycle, with most of the server-side scripting languages. It's based on HTTP response and request cycle. So this is how PHP works. It runs on the server. You need a web server to execute the PHP script. And so here the web server can be an Apache. In our previous lessons in Web Technology 1, we learned an example of web servers. Web servers, we said we have Apache as a web server, we have IIS, we have engines, we have Lightspeed. There are other web servers out there, but these are the popular web servers. So all these web servers, we can what? Install PHP on them, or we can host PHP on them. So this is just a brief introduction or overview of the PHP programming language. We said it's an interpreted language. It supports dark typing and start, and then it's loosely typed. It runs on a web server. And it's an open source. The most important feature of PHP is open source and platform independent. Open source. I think PHP is licensed under the Apache Foundation. When we say a language in computer science open source, we mean that language doesn't have, there's no proprietary ownership to it. It is a community driven language. So here, the PHP, the developer is there as Ramos, and there's a community supporting Ramos to come up with the PHP specification requirement, PSR. PHP specification requirement is generated by the lead, the one who designed the language, plus the community. So PHP is an open source because there's no proprietary company, there's no company specifically owning this language. Unlike Java, where we have part owned by Oracle and part owned by the community. Or a language like right now, C Sharp is also, Microsoft has made it open source. But a language like Swift, Microsoft, I think Oracle and Apple has given part as open source. But Swift is purposely owned by Apple. The license is not owned by the community. When a language is open source, it means the source code is available. You can download it and modify it. Just that you must conform to the license. The Apache, maybe it's an Apache license. So the lead, the one who designed the landing, and he has a committee following him. So when the lead and the committee come together, they come up with what we call the specification requirements for the language. So this is how the open source community work. When they are done with everything, they will come up with a version. And the current version in release now is PHP 8.0, which I think is in the beta, in the testing stage. But if you want a stable version of the PHP, you go for PHP 7.4. These are supported by most web servers. This is a stable version. This one is in testing, or what you call a beta release. But this is stable on the master release. So PHP is an open source, and we said it's a what? A platform dependent, the independent language. The source code in Windows can be copied to Unix or Linux, and it will run perfectly. Unlike C and C++, where we have so many versions. The ISO, we have ISO C++ and ANSI C++ and all those things. And C and code, there should be different compilers for various platforms. No. But here with PHP, you just port and it runs. Like Java. So PHP is open source. PHP is platform independent. And we said the latest version is 7.4. That's the stable version of PHP, 7.4. And it's a community-driven language, meaning there's support from the PHP community in improving the language. And that community comes with what we call the PHP specification requirements. This is the document that specifies the features of the language at a particular time. The PHP specification requirement is a document that specifies the features of the language at a particular time. So let's look at variables in PHP. How to declare variables. So we have seen the overview, the simple features of PHP. You can read along there. I'll post a lot of books on the e-learning platform, and then there'll be a forum discussion there, and I'll rank all of you. So everyone is entitled, or so you look at the variables in PHP. What is a variable? A variable is a space or a storage in memory. A variable is a storage in memory or a space. Or let me use the word a slot. A slot to hold data in memory. In memory. A space to hold data in memory is called a variable. And in PHP, variables are defined with a dollar sign. So for the PHP interpreter to recognize a figure as a variable, the variable must start with a dollar sign. So dollar A means what? Variable A. In Java and C++, to show that A is a variable, you have to say int A. Or you have to give A a type. But like we said beforehand, PHP is not a static type language. It's not composed to give it a type. So here we know that A is an integer, but here we don't know the type of A till runtime. At runtime, the interpreter will know the type of A. But with the compiled languages, at compile time, we know the type of A. But with interpreted languages or dynamic languages, unless at runtime, before we know the type of A. So here we said to declare A as a variable, we have to bring the dollar sign in front of the name of the variable. So we prepend the variable name with a dollar sign. So we say dollar A is equal to 2. And all PHP statements are terminated with what? A semicolon. All PHP statements are terminated with a semicolon. So when we say dollar A is the variable. And the value of A is what? 2. And when we say dollar B, is equal to 4. The name of the variable is B, and the value of B is what? 4. So if you are doing a simple arithmetic like dollar C, first of all, you declare dollar C as what? 0. If you don't bring 0 here, dollar C become null. Note this way. If you don't initialize C, C default in memory is null, which is not supported in the compiled language, but in dynamic language, when you declare a variable without initializing it this way, the value of the variable becomes